Hello, I'm Junfeng Huang, the process chemist in therapeutic development branch of NCATS. I'm leading process and scale-up group. Welcome to our scale-up and process lab. In here, we are trying to develop a scalable, controllable, robust, and safe process to manufacture a large quantity of the APIs to support preclinical and clinical development in NCATS. Early development stage will need tens to hundreds grams of APIs to support preclinical activities, and up to kilogram APIs to support GLP and phase one clinical trial. The timely delivery of sufficient APIs with high quality will be an ultimate goal of our group. We are a rate-determining step in the drug development process. All the clinical trials and the GLP studies cannot begin until we have sufficient APIs. Unlike medicinal chemists who's using one set of conditions for different substrates and perform the reactions in benchhood, process chemists are trying to find a perfect reaction condition for only one substrate, and the reaction was performed in a working hood. The reactor size in here is ranging from 5 liter to 22 liter. The reaction was worked up in 5 to 20 liter drain flask to mimic the real manufacture condition. The organic solvents from the workup will be removed on our 20 liter industrial scale rotor vapor. We can easily remove 20 liters of organic solvent in less than 1 hour. This rotor vapor also helps us to remove the residue water from the walk-up using azeotrope technology. We can also perform crystallization and trituration in here to purify the crude material. The quality of API directly affects the potency and safety of the drug. Process development work requires a high level of analytical instrumentation for analytical method development. We use in-house HPLC and GC mass for analytical method development work on intermediates, IPAs, and starting materials. This instrumentation helps us to identify the impurity profile of the API and intermediates, figure out the critical quality contribution of the process, and set up the in-process checkpoint. In most cases, APIs are obtained as a solid, which will be further analyzed by optical microscope, TGA, and DSC to determine their physical chemical properties. The optical microscope was constructed by ourselves with polarizing light set and the digital display, which will reveal whether this solid is a crystalline or not. Thermal gravity analyze, TGA, measures a sample's mass when it is heated. It can give us the degradation behavior of the compound in heating, review thermal stability region of the APIs and determine the volatile fractions of the compound. Differential scanning calorimetry, DSC, is the most common thermal analytical technology for solid state. It tells how much energy a sample absorbs or releases during heating, and gives us the solid form transition information, such as glass transition, crystallization, and melting. Generally, a sharp endothermic peak of API over 200 degrees indicates a potential stable form of API. The process developed in this lab will be further test transferred to a good manufacture practice lab in contract manufacture organizations. They will produce GMP grade of the material in large quantity, such as kilogram, to support the GLP and phase one clinical trial. The material generated in this lab will be also used by our other groups to do the development work, such as formulation group. Our goal of the lab is closely associated to the goals of the NCATS and the TDB. We are trying to accelerate the development of a therapeutic treatment for the disease with high unmet needs.
Welcome to the formulation and manufacturing team in NCATS NIH. My name is Hak Sung Jin. I'm a pharmacist and team lead for formulation and manufacturing. My colleague, Dr. Molly Kongdon, and I are working together to develop formulations.
Hi, I'm Molly Kongdon, a scientist in the formulations team within the therapeutic development branch, or TDB. Our group helps bridge the bench to bedside transition from preclinical studies into clinical trials. Our work focuses on developing dosage forms of raw materials such as small molecules, peptides, oligonucleotides, recombinant proteins, and gene therapy vectors. These formulations include capsules, injectables, nasal sprays, or eye drops, depending upon the target product profile, and are administered in humans during phase 1 clinical trials.
Currently, we work with contract development and manufacturing organization to complete the formulation development of dosage forms and ensure the material is manufactured according to the current good manufacturing practice. Additionally, we collect all the documents related to drug product manufacturing to complete the investigational new drug application submitted to the Food and Drug Administration. Once the application is approved, our collaborator can begin the phase 1 clinical study.
In order to expedite the development and delivery of new therapeutics to the public, we have designed and are in the process of building our own formulations laboratory. Currently, our formulation lab is under construction and will be completed by the second quarter of 2023. We will focus on small molecule formulation, research and development, as well as developing scalable manufacturing processes. Currently, we are acquiring equipment that will facilitate formulation development, especially with any active pharmaceutical ingredient bearing low water solubility.
To facilitate preparation of formulated material, the lab space will be equipped with powder mixer and blender, capsule maker or manual capsule filling machine, microfluidizer, spray dryer, 3D printer, and stability chambers.
In order to develop a new dosage form, the physical properties of the formulation will be analyzed by measuring its bulk density, homogenation, viscosity, dissolution profile, particle size distribution, subvisible particle characterization, and hot stage microscopy. Additional equipment that will help us evaluate the formulations include high performance liquid chromatography, melting point apparatus, and Carl Fischer moisture titrators.
The goals for building a new formulation lab are to develop high throughput solubility screening of water insoluble active pharmaceutical ingredient, and also expedite the formulation development and clinical study by utilizing 3D tablet manufacturing. Finally, perform tech transfer of innovative formulation to the GMP manufacturing. The ultimate goal of the formulation team is to focus on our NCATS mission by delivering more treatments to more patients more quickly through accelerated formulation development.